All right, we're going to do some testing on this flyback right here and the driver. Right now, what we're going to look at is this power pack here. This is 12 volts at 4.15 amps. Now, it's got a lot more amps than I like to use, so let's find out what it does. Let's go ahead and set this up. Now, the actual piece of copper right there is connected to the negative, and we're now going to power this on. Okay, it's on. I'm now going to use a piece of pliers right here. Let's see, that's a lot of amps in there. See all that white? See all that? Yeah, that's not going to be good. We're looking for a static volt in this thing, and you see all that white right there. Relatively low voltage, but the amps are fairly high for what we want to do. So, yeah, that's probably not going to work out. That's not a good power source for us. You can see I'm pulling it and holding it. What I'm looking for is to see if it pulls off and gives us any of the static volts. It's basically a purple color that would come off of this thing. And I'm not getting it. I'm just getting white. All right, let's move on to the second one. This one's not going to work. So, let's make sure we unplug it. God knows I've gotten shocked enough. Okay, second power source here. Untangle it. This is the one I usually use. It has 19 volts, 2.37 amps. Right there is where you need to look at it. I'll show a better picture of this. But let's hook this up. Again, if you strip these wires back, just so you can see, the negative is the shielding. It comes around right here. The positive is the wire. And sometimes these things suck. Sometimes they work out. Let's see. Now we got that all hooked up, let's plug it in. Okay, here we go. Oh, there we go. Now you're starting to see it spark over, and immediately I get that smell in the air. That ozone smell. There's the white very close. You notice how the spark isn't as big and it's intermittent now? Now, I don't know if it's showing it, but I'm getting those little purple spikes. I'll see if I can't freeze frame it for you and take a picture. And then look at that. I can hear the sound. You can see it right there at the top. See it glowing right there at the end? It's exactly what we're looking for. This is why I use this power source a lot. Right there. That's that hissing sound. That's what we're looking at. That one works out good. Okay, I like that one. Let's try one more. Alright, all power's off. Let's disconnect it. One thing to keep in mind, by the way, these always have a little bit left in there, so just make sure you do that. Because getting zapped is never fun. I took the full front of one yesterday, and trust me, it was not fun. So again, I'll show you here. Here we got the wire. We're just going to strip it back. Let's go a little more. And then we'll take the shielding here. We'll pull it back. Just twist that off right there. And we got the lid there, make sure there's absolutely no more on there. Twist that end. Now, let's hook this thing up. And all right, here we go. All we're gonna do now is plug this thing in. And we're hot. Let's see if this thing does anything. Again, this power pack is 12 volt, but 1.5 amp. I don't even know if it's gonna be enough to drive it. Let's see. Oh yeah, we got the right color, relatively low power. That's not going to be enough power. You can still see though that we're getting the purple because we have less amps, right about right there. We're getting that purple, we're getting a small hiss. And again, the spark. So I'm getting right now a lot of the ozone smell again. On that very first power pack, I got no ozone smell. And that kind of led to why I was testing this, because I was going to use that 12 volt with four amps, and it just sucked. This right here is just not enough power. I'm not getting enough spark over. So let's unplug this. What are we looking at as our winner, guys? Guys, I probably knew this from the beginning, but I want to make sure you guys did. This right here, and 19 volts and 2.3 amps. Now, you're probably wondering, can I use one of these? Now, the problem I found is, is this display right here completely not working? So we'll give it a shot. Let's go ahead and change this out. This one did come with this handy quick connect, which I do like. Makes it so I don't have to cut everything off, but I don't really care. I solder everything anyway. So just line up positive, positive. All right, let's go ahead and plug that in there. Wrong side. Okay. Plug that in there. Plug this in here. Okay. Straighten it out. Now look, I just turned it on. There we go. We got something now. Okay. Well, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it'll work today. Here we go. Here we go. Let's try it out. And we got something. Let's see if we can control it. Don't have a whole lot going on there. Oh, yeah, we can. Oh, man. Maybe it was just me. There we go. We got way too many amps, though. You can see the white going in there. And it just shut off. It does not like running these things. So here we go, we're just not getting a good mix. So right there, it just overamped it. Now we're going to bring it down. It's got too little. I'm still not getting this ozone smell right here. Again, it just went too many amps. Too little. Way too many. Yeah, the mix sucks. Yeah, I don't like this at all. I mean, if you want to get a spark out of it, I guess it's okay. But for what I'm looking for in this, this is not, you know, and there it goes dead again. All right. Yeah, that one's a bad one. That's just not going to work. I can't deal with the inconsistency of it. Again, we know what our winner is. Anyway, I hope this helps you guys out in figuring out what you need. If I were you, I would just get one of these Toshibas here with the 19 volts and a couple amps. And that's what I would recommend to use on this. If you like what you saw here today, please like, share, subscribe, do all those fun things, and have yourself a great day. Thank you.